Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum students. Farais here from Outstanding Nurses Hub. Today we are going to talk about the auscultation of the heart sounds. It is very important topic because heart sounds, most of the time we have to auscultate the heart sound of the patients, and sometimes students become confused which area we have to auscultate for heart sounds, and what points are there which we have on the chest cavity that we must consider, and after that how can we memorize. So it's good news that today we are discussing about heart sounds, where we have to auscultate the heart sounds, what are the parts of the heart which we have to auscultate, and points on the chest cavity as well. And after that we will discuss I will give you a trick and mnemonic. With the help of that mnemonic, you will be able to understand, to memorize, to remember, to recall the points of the auscultation. Okay. And prior to start of the video, please, if you are new on my channel, please subscribe to my channel so you will be able to get notifications of lot of videos. Right. Okay. Let's start. First of all, you know that heart has four valves. Right. Broadly, we are dividing the heart into two parts. First one is atrioventricular valve, and second one is semilunar valve. In atrioventricular valve, there is mitral valve, and second one is tricuspid valve. Mitral valve, the second name of the mitral valve, is also bicuspid. So between the atria and ventricle, on the right side of the heart, that is tricuspid valve. Right, and between the atria, left atria and left ventricle, there is a valve which is called mitral valve. Okay, these two are atrioventricular valve, and the next is semilunar valve. Semilunar valves consist of, first one is pulmonic valve. Okay, pulmonic valve, or and the second one is aortic valve. Okay, so it's very important to understand that sound produces at a particular valve are more clearly audible at a particular part of the precordium. Okay, precordium. What is precordium? Okay, precordium is the area where the heart overlies the heart, right? Area of the chest where the heart lies. Right. In next slide, I will tell you about this in detail with the pictorial aid. Okay, so as we said earlier, that the area of the valve, the heart sounds for which is producing by the mitral valve, will be better audible at the area of mitral area, right? And the sound which is produced by the tricuspid valve will be clearly audible at the tricuspid area. Okay, and the mitral area is corresponding to the apex, and tricuspid area is close to the part of the sternum at fourth intercostal space. In next video, in next slide, I will discuss it in detail with the help of a diagram. Right, in this way you will be able to better understand. Right, and pulmonic area, which we said that it is a semilunar valve. Right. Pulmonary valve lies between the pulmonic, okay, right ventricle and pulmonic arteries. Okay, and aortic valve lies between the aorta and the left ventricle. Okay, and the aorta is subdivided into two parts. First one is aortic one, and second one is aortic two. That is called Arbs area. Right, Arbs area. We also call it Arbs area, and aortic two area. Okay, A1 and A2. Okay. Now we are clear that there are four types of valves: mitral valve, tricuspid valve, and the other types are pulmonary valve and aortic valve. Areas we will discuss in next slide, because it will be better. You will be better able to understand that. Okay. First of all, we talk about the aortic area. Aortic area, which lies, this is the chest cavity in front of the from here there is second intercostal space, and this is sternum. Okay, this is aortic area. Aortic area lies there close to the sternum in the second intercostal space. Okay, This is aortic area, and we will be able to better understand, better hear the sound of aortic area or aortic valve at this area. Okay, see. First one is aortic area, which is close to the sternum on the right side of the heart, and second intercostal space. And in front of this, there is second intercostal space on the left side of the heart, which is also close to the sternum. Okay, and this is pulmonary area, right? And third one is third intercostal space. Third intercostal space, this is A2 area. A2 mean ABS area. We also call it ABS area or aortic 2 area. Aortic 1 is here, aortic 2 is here. And next one is fourth intercostal space. On fourth intercostal space, there is tricuspid area. And it is also close to the sternum. All these points are first. First one is aortic, pulmonic, ABS area, and tricuspid. These all are close to sternum, right? And the next area, which is fifth intercostal space on the left side of the heart, and that is midclavicular. Draw a line from, this is clavicle, and draw a line in between the clavicle and come and on the fifth intercostal space, this is mitral valve. Okay, so this area which overlies the heart from right side of the chest, second intercostal space, to the fifth intercostal space on the left side, midclavicular, this area is the precordium. Okay, this area which overlies the heart, normally heart is in between this one, and this is called what? Precordium. Okay, and all sounds are better audible on its particular area, right? First of all, aortic sound will be better audible here, and second one is pulmonic sound will be better audible here. A2 means aortic 2 or ABS area, because aorta, ascending aorta, and that then it descend, that's why this is aortic 2 area, right? And further, just remember it, that only one point which you have to auscultate on the right side of the heart, that is aortic area, right? A for aortic, A, it is the first letter of the alphabets. So you can remember it in this way, that first area is aortic area, and only one point where we have to auscultate on the right side of the heart, that is second intercostal space close to the sternum, and it is aortic area. Rest of the points are on the left side, because our heart lies on the left side of the chest, right? So these are close to the sternum, and one point which is mitral, that is away from the sternum on the fifth intercostal space, but it is midclavicular. Okay, I think so you can understand. In next let's practice, and we will understand that how can we remember all these points when we are going to auscultate a patient's heart sounds. Okay, this is a trick. First of all, what is the area? Okay, yeah. Aortic area, right? So remember it, all physicians, PHYSICIAN physicians, okay, all physicians R-E-A-R-N-R, okay, too, okay, much. And this is fact. Okay, just remember it. All physicians aren't too much, right? Okay, first of all, take the A. Okay, this is A. A for aortic. Aortic. Okay, and next one is physician. Physician P. P. Okay, P. P for pulmonic. Pulmonic. Right, pulmonic area. Next one is E. E for? E. Okay. E for ABS area. ABS. Right? ABS area. Right? Area. Okay. Next one is, all physicians aren't too much. Two. Okay. Two. Two for tricuspid. Tricuspid. Okay. Next one is, All physicians earn too much. Next one is M. M. Okay. Much. Mitral. Mitral. Okay, students. See it that all physicians earn too much. If you are not able to remember the physician because it is PH and you have to, you can understand in this way. All pilots earn too much. That is also a fact. Huh? All pilots earn too much. Right? In this way, we will be able to memorize or to recall the points. All physicians earn too much. Okay, this is aortic area. Where is the aortic area? We have learned that only one area which is situated on the right side of the heart near to the sternum. Second intercostal space, that is aortic area. Okay, and second one, we come to the left side of the sternum, and there is pulmonic area. That is on the second intercostal space. And after that, there is Abs area, which is on the third intercostal space, right side of the sternum or close to the sternum, right? And next one is Tricuspid area, which is on the subsequent intercostal space, that is fourth intercostal space. And Mitral area, which is on the fifth intercostal space, but it is mid-clavicular, okay? And these areas are the precordium as well, okay? Aortic area on which second intercostal space, okay, and right side, okay. I don't consider on the work on the these slides, and I just consider on the material and your understanding. Pulmonic area is second intercostal space on the left side, because all other points are on the left side normally. Next one is Abs area, that is third intercostal space, okay, and left side, right? And next one is tricuspid area is on the fourth intercostal space. Intercostal space, okay, and it is on the left side. Next one is mitral is on the fifth intercostal space and on the left side, okay, left side. And one more thing, okay, yes, that is mid clavicular, okay. So this is all from my side, from my 2 days video. I hope you will understand aortic area, pulmonic area, tricuspid area and mitral area. And this is also precordium, 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 right? All physicians earn too much. I am going to auscultate a patient. Okay, keep it in mind. All physicians earn too much. All pilots earn too much. Okay, in this way you will be able to remember that. I hope you will understand all the stuff which I have discussed today, and you also enjoy the pleasure of learning as well. Please do comment and like my video and share it with your friends. If you have any query, just let me know and give me comments. I will answer you all. This is my channel, Outstanding Nurses Hub. Oh, it's missing here. No problem. I know you understand that it's an Outstanding Nurses Hub, right? Outstanding Nurses Hub. Just subscribe it. So you will be able to get the notifications of the next series, because in subsequent series, I am going to discuss about the circulation of the heart, what are the normal sounds of the heart, and what are the abnormal sounds of the heart, and other diseases of the heart as well. Okay, thank you very much. Take care.